Good morning, everybody. My name is James Moore, and today we're going to talk about the Billboard charts. Now, what are the Billboard charts? Some of you may be wondering. They are charts that are specifically catered towards weekly rankings and popularity of songs and albums in the United States, and they also have year-end charts for every year. How does this work? Well, every week, songs and albums are ranked on a chart system that consists of 100 songs and 200 albums. I'm supposed to say 200, not 100, my bad. And songs are ranked based on weekly airplay on radio stations, digital sales, award show performances, streaming, and the use of songs in other forms of pop culture or like social media to help promote the song. And how they're calculated. Back in the day, in the 50s and 60s, they used jukeboxes to tally the results of albums and songs each week. And then as technology grew, they stopped doing that and they just went manually to stores and asking, hey, what did you guys play today? That song sounds great. Let's write on this paper. That's what they did. And then they kept doing that method until November of 1991, where they began using the Nielsen SoundScan, which is basically technology where they use where they can hear like specifically what song is playing on the radio at a specific time. And nowadays, like we use like iTunes and YouTube and easier stuff to make the Billboard charts even easier. And the Billboard charts started in the year 1955. And there's many different charts, like on the Billboard charts. You have pop, which is like one of the main ones, electronic, Latin, country, adult contemporary, bluegrass. Some of these actually don't exist anymore, like bluegrass, because you know, that's not really like popular anymore. Or classical doesn't really exist. Those are just a few of what we have on the charts. And what we're going to talk about is the main Billboard chart, which is Billboard Hot 100, where all of the songs, like no matter what genre, are clumped together. And 1958 was when they started doing the Billboard Hot 100 chart. So this is the first Billboard number one hit single. Called Poor Little Fool by
I used to play around the foundation at my car. But when I met that little girl, I knew that I would fall for a little fool. Oh yeah.
I'm guessing he was like a teen heartthrob back in the day. I don't know where he's at now. He's probably dead, but... Can anybody guess what the current number one hit is right now in America? Anybody?
If you could give us a singer, I think you
okay. It is...
I knew it!
In my head.
Yeah, it's currently number one right now as of the week, October 4th, 2015. And here are some Billboard records. These are the artists that have had the most number one hits in America. The Beatles, Mariah Carey, and Elvis Presley. And this song has spent the most weeks in the top 10.
Don't know.
10 weeks, but these are the songs I spent 10 weeks in the number one spot. We Found Love, Happy, as we can hear in the background. That's good, physical. These songs spent number one for 11 weeks. This is a song that's playing for those of you. It's a song from like the 90s, so when we were all here. And these are the songs I spent number one for 2 weeks. This is the song that's playing right now. You all know this.
Charts. So, that's a speech. All right.